That he does.
So he tells me, he says, come speak in my church. I'm like, nah, bro, like, you see how I'm living? I don't think I'll be a good fit. I'm not there yet. A lot of us know that word, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not there yet. Not realizing God wants to use you exactly how you are, because when you get delivered, guess who gets the credit?
Come on! Woo!
So stop waiting for the perfect time. The perfect time that exists is not tomorrow, because tomorrow's not promised. It's not next week, because next week is not promised. The perfect time that exists is right now.
Yeah.
So stop living like tomorrow is guaranteed.
Yeah.
Don't live an incomplete life. Don't wish you would have did this and that. It starts tonight. Hope it already started for you. So he says, Trent, I see some of you see yourself. And I'm like, okay, cool. He said, what? You scared? I'm like, no, I'm not scared. I was scared. Because I said my debut speech in front of all these stuff. He says, I can rap at your church. He said, no. I see some of you see yourself. I said, okay, fine. Who am I speaking to, right? He says, were you speaking to teenagers? I was like, oh, I'm done. Nope. If y'all does not laugh, you never spoke in front of teenagers. Because they'll make you feel like the most boring, interesting person in the world. Like this. I already know this, my mom told me. So I'm like, I need my confidence, and I'm going to keep doing this. This is my purpose that you see inside of me. I don't see inside of myself. What, you scared? No, okay, I get you. Well, okay, teenagers, how many? Let's get this. He said, I'm about 4 to 5,000. What? Let me get this straight. I've never really spoken in front of a big crowd. I feel like I'm not qualified for it. Teenagers, 4 to 5,000? Nah, I'm not. You tripping, bro. What? You scared? I'm like, oh my gosh. It's not going to keep working. I said, okay, fine. Teenagers, 25,000. I can go in and talk about football, maybe 30 seconds to a minute. I'm good. Right? I'm good. I can hold it down for them. Maybe I can rap and spit some bars. Make it clean. So I said, okay, let me get this. I said, how long do you want me to speak? He says, I'm about 5 to 7 minutes. I'm out. 5 to 7 minutes? Are you crazy? I was making rehab. There were rehabish videos. I was like, trying to find my way. I said, have you seen my videos? All I can give you is 2 minutes, dog. 2 minutes is all I got to take. And y'all know, because that's exactly what y'all get. I might give you 2 minutes and 30 seconds on a rare occasion, 2:45. So he says, what? You scared? All right, get you. I'll do it. So I'm like, okay, I know exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to go home. I'm going to rehearse it just like I'm writing a rap. So I'm going to rehearse this till I know it. And I knew it. Word from I ran over it. Anybody out of their first speech, they go over like 20,000 times, right? That was me. I was good. So I get to the venue. He sees me backstage, and I'm dressed like this, right? And it's funny, if I'm dressed like this, I want to speak about this, because I was speaking one time. And somebody told me, like, I think it was a message. It's like, I came to your show, and you don't dress like a Christian.
What?
And I was like, I never knew it. I never knew being a Christian came with a dress code. The uniform don't make somebody evil, the heart does.
Yeah.
And I said, maybe next time I'll wear some sandals for you. Woo! Always judging. So I get back there and I'm like dressed like this, have my tattoos out, whatever. And he's like, man, I'm glad you wore that. It's like, why? He's like, first of all, I see some of you singing. Yeah, okay. You scared? Yes, I am scared, actually. He said, don't trip. You got dreads and tattoos. They gonna think you 2 Chainz anyway. I'm like, you didn't keep there. You should have came on that. The Sandman when it came out, bro. You know what I'm talking about, Apollo? Some of y'all too young for that, right? That's how long, you know, I say it because it's been quiet. Make a long story short, I go on the stage and I'm scared. I grab the mic and everything I rehearse went out the window. I'm like, oh, I'm in trouble. So my prayer then is my prayer to this day. And I learned to always speak from the heart. That's why I go all over the place when I'm speaking. Because I feel like God's going to use me and touch who he wants to touch.
Right.
And my prayer was, God, use me. Mm-hmm. And at that moment, I felt the power. I felt the power. And these kids, even to this day, I've never seen a crowd this glued to what I was saying. And at that moment, I knew that God had something greater for me. I knew that this is what he has called me to do. And everything in my life made sense. All my past, all the struggle, all the mistakes, all the being cuts from football teams made sense in that moment. I get off stage and all these kids run up to me. Like, tell me more about God. Like, you're cool. Like, tell me more about God. I'm like, man, I should be asking you. You're here, I'm raised in the church, but I'm battling, I'm struggling. Like, I don't know what to say. I don't know how to say the right things to you. And I realize sometimes we cut ourselves from sharing God's word because we want to say the right things. Don't you know just sharing God's word is the right thing?
Yeah.
Sometimes just offering a smile and saying, I'm praying for you, can save somebody's life.
Right.
You don't have to sit there and quote all these quotes and things like that. Speak from the heart.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you speak from the heart, you know God is using you.
Yeah.
So I told God this. I made a deal with God. I don't know if you ever did that. When you were in trouble, you know when you were in trouble.
Yeah.
I go to church every Sunday. I'm praying to you. I'm praying to you. And as soon as he gives you what you pray for, so I say, God, if this is my purpose, if this is what you called me to do, talk to him like this. You better show me. He didn't respond back. Had to make 3 phone calls that day. Harmless. What was to a team I was supposed to go to in New Orleans? I called the coach and he picks up, hello? Because I already postponed the date. I was supposed to be there that day, but I asked, can I speak? So he pushed it back to Saturday. He says, hello? I was like, yeah, coach, I'm not going to say this, but I'm just saying it like this. I'm not coming. Why? I'm just not feeling football no more. I don't even like arena football. It's crazy. It should be banned. It's illegal. My body hurts. I'm feeling like that. You want the truth. I'm just doing this because I have nothing else to do. I'm holding on to football out of fear.
Wow.
The fear of what? The fear of who would I be without it?
Mm.
The fear of what? The fear of how I'm going to pay my bills and take care of my family. Some of us are holding on to our situations out of fear. And that's how you know you're in the wrong situation, when you're not holding on to it out of love, but you're holding on to it out of fear.
Yeah. That's good. That's good.
And so I made this call. And the guy said, I'm going to be a speaker. Rehab time. He said, what? Click.
Mm.
He hangs up on me. And I'm like, God, you all for what?
Yeah.
Are you supposed to go 3 for 3? You all for what? I'm going back. Send the call I make. It's to my friends. Really, they weren't my friends. They're like my associates, just to be honest with you, because I found that out later on.
Yeah.
And some of my friends, they won't. And some of my friends are here today that I love dearly. Close friends that have been through me through thick and thin, always been there. And they was like, I don't know, do it. They supported it. They didn't know what I was going to do. I didn't know what I was going to do. They supported it. Then I had the friends that said, you crazy. You going to leave this lifestyle? In Fort Worth, being known, being able to go out and do what you want to do? Because that NFL lifestyle is something crazy a lot of people don't know about. You have access to anything that you want. Anything. You going to leave all of that? Why they were saying that? Because guess what? They know if I left that, guess what? The benefits would stop. And I'm going to tell you right now, some people's loyalty ends where the benefits stop.
Yeah.
And so right now I'm thinking, God, you 0 for 2. Like, I'm going back. 0 for 2 is not good. It's not a good percentage. Even if you go 1 for 3, you're 33%. That's not good. I need 75 or something. So I had to make the hardest call. And I don't know if she remembers this. She should. But you know you have that period that you call, and like, you're trying to debate who to call, because like, you want somebody to talk, like, you know, it's like your mom and your dad. I hope they answer the phone. I hope it's her. So for me, honestly, I didn't want my dad to pick up. And he's not here right now. But I didn't want to pick up. Why? Because I made up this lie that he only cared about me and my family. I'll just be real, everybody, honestly, only cared about me for football. Because they were so proud. Like, my parents and my brothers, they talk about, they don't care what I'm doing, I can be whatever. They were celebrating, they're proud. I have the most supportive family in the world, I feel like. But I told myself, they only care about this, the lies that we tell ourselves. We tell ourselves so many lies until we start to believe those as true. And we start to live that lie as it's true. So I had to like tell myself, that's stupid. You know they care about you, know they love you. My mom picks up the phone. And I say, Mom, first say, hey baby, how you doing? My mom calls me every single day, even when I'm staring at baby boy, right? I want to talk about any babies in here?
I'm the only one.
Shut up, baby.